everyone, it's Steph here from feancards.blogspot.co.uk and I'm an independent Stampin Up demonstrator in the UK. I just want to share with you today another storage unit that I've done. This one is for my Twine storage. I was sick of it lying all over, so I decided to come up with this. It's got four drawers and in each of the four drawers it holds two rolls of the Stampin Up Twine. This one I made using garden green card, Delightful Dijon and a retired paper from the autumn winter catalogue, which was the Warmth and Cheer. So let's get started and show you what you need. Right, first of all we're going to do the drawer sleeves. These are in the same fashion as me house styled storage caddy, so if you watch that, I appreciate all of your support and all of the people who subscribed to me and left me so many lovely comments. Thank you very much. Right, so this is the same size as the drawer sleeve that we used on the other one nearly. It is 8 1/4 by 2 3/4. Then you need to score it on the long side at 1/2 inch, 2 inches, 4 3/8 inch and 5 7/8. You need 4 of these, 1 for each drawer. So now we'll just fold and burnish all of our score lines. Right, so then it will look something like that. Then what we need is we need some sticky strip, or you could use fast views on this 1/2 inch strip here. So, oops. Sorry about that, I dropped my pokey tool. For this I'm using Stampin Up's Tear and Tape. This is a really nice strong adhesive and it's great because you just tear it like so. And just smooth that down, take off the release paper and then just fold it together, line it up and like that. If you want to just run over it with your bone folder just to make sure that it's stuck. So once again we'll be left with this ready for our drawer to go in. We'll pop that to one side and we'll get the piece of card that we've, oh sorry, I meant to mention, this card here that I've used is Flirty Flamingo. It's one of the in colours in Stampin' Up. It's beautiful. Next you will need for the drawers, you will need 4 of these. And these measure 5 1/2 by 5 1/8. Then what you want to do is score it on all 4 sides at 1 3/8. So what we'll do now is we'll just go ahead and fold and burnish. This, if you can gather, is our basic black cardstock. Just love the idea of black and pink together. It's one of my favourite colour combos. Then once it's all scored, you take our snips and in each of these corners we need to cut up the score line and then wedge out, and I'll show you what I mean. This is just to do your box base for your twine to go in. Cut up the score line, take out the wedge and then wedge out on the other side and you'll be left with something that looks like that. Then what I like to do, as per my last video, I like to rotate at 90 degrees. This is just because with it being such a small drawer, it doesn't mean that there's going to be too much bulk on just 2 sides of the box. It's all evenly distributed. So then again, rotate, cut up the score line and then take a wedge out. Oh, a bit cockeyed. And then just take a wedge out of the other side, rotate it and do that again. This is the last one now. Cutting very straight today. Just get rid of these little bits of rubbish. Now what we want to do is, this is when I like to put my DSP on, like the last video. So the paper I'm using today is actually a celebration item and I'll show you that. This paper is called Inside the Lines and it is absolutely stunning. For all those people out there who love adult colouring books and stuff like that, this is the paper for you. You get 12 12 by 12 sheets and you get 4 designs, 3 of each. So we have this one, this is the one I'm using today. Then we have this one. This one will coordinate great with our Dragonfly Dreams bundle. You've got the matching dragonflies here and even the little bees. And another one. And finally, this is the last one with loads of beautiful flowers and the bumblebees on there. With this being a celebration item, for every £45 you spend at Stampin Up up until the 31st of March, you can pick a free celebration item. And it's just, honestly, it's great. I love this. And the amount of stuff that, lovely stuff that they've got on there at the moment is just brilliant. So what I've done is, I'll just get me little pieces of DSP that I've cut down. These is for the drawers, and these measure 2 1/8 by 1 1/8. And you need 2 for each drawer. So you will need 8. And then what I like to do is I just like to put this on here now, because it's easier than doing it when the box is done. So I'll just get my Tombow out. As you know from my last video, this is one of my favourite glue at the moment, the wet glue. It's absolutely beautiful. And then just line it up on one of these sections here. Just make sure that it's as square as can be and as straight as can be. And that is how it'll look. I think the black, the pink and the white just looks so beautiful. And then what I want to do is, as per the last video, I'm going to take my 1/8 hole punch from Stampin' Up. And I'm going to eyeball it, and I'm going to just try and do it as centre as possible. So just line it up. And once you're happy with it, that's you have a hole. Then I need some more tearing tape, because I'm going to turn it over. And on either side of this hole here, you can see I'm just going for a little bit of double-sided sticky tape, just for when I thread the ribbon through, it gives the ribbon something to stick to and keep it nice and secure. We don't want it falling out when we try and open our drawers. So just pop a piece down like that, and then like that as well. Make sure it's down properly, and just, you can take the release paper off that now. This is all ready to put our ribbon through. Right, the ribbon I am using today, one second, where's it gone? Oh, it's on the floor. One second while I try and pick my ribbon up off the floor without knocking the camera all over. I do apologise. Right, got it. Oh, I've just knocked the camera. Sorry about that. It's because my phone's on charge as well, so it's, my camera setup is still as dodgy as the first one, because I still haven't gotten my new tripod yet. So I've just took a little bit of black ribbon. This isn't Stampin' Up, because I don't have any black ribbon from Stampin' Up, so I've just used some from my stash. Again, fold it in half and then push it through from the inside. Just bear with me. Everything seems to take twice as long when I'm trying to do it on camera. Doesn't want to go through for me today. But I will, I'll get it through. There we go. Right, so what I've done is I've pulled it through there. Once you're happy with the length, then what you can do is just keep hold of it and just splay your ribbon and put one on each side of the sticky tape to secure it in place. Next, what we want to do is we want to put adhesive on these 4 tabs, and then we can construct our box. So again, just going to use some tearing tape for this. Nice and strong, and it's nice and quick too. I do apologise for how much I'm knocking the camera today. Like I said, I've had to put my phone on charge. I forgot to charge it before I decided to do this video. I thought I was all well organised. Need on just a couple more to do, and for each of the drawers you would construct them in exactly the same way that we're going through now. I don't know if you just heard that there, my kitty's sitting on the window and she's making lots of noises watching out. She loves watching out the window, she's so noisy. Hopefully she'll stay where she is. so far. Right, so now they're all hats on, you're just going to take off the release paper. Like so. So now that we've got all of the sides off, you just want to fold that in like that and match it up so it's nice and flush with that side, and then just stick it down and then go around and do exactly the same on each of the other sides, making sure that be straight, nice and flush. And there we go, that's all done. Just going as normal as I normally do. I just like to get my bone folder in there and just make sure that they're down. Now to hide all of the workings, you've still got a bit of sticky strip in there and you can see a bit of the ribbon. That's what my second piece of my DSP is for, and I'm just going to apply it with some Tombow and just lie it on the inside like so. So let's get that done. Oops, it's alive today. And we're just going to pop that in like so. I forgot to mention, on my designer series paper, when I cut and prepped all of these, you can see it's pink. What I've got is I purchased the Stampin' Up markers in the 2016-2018 in colours, in Flirty Flamingo, which is the colour of the card I've used. I've incorporated that and coloured some of the bits in on each of the DSP panels just so it ties it all together. These are available on my online store. If you want to buy any Stampin' Up products, then please head over to my blog at effiancards.blogspot.co.uk, or alternatively I am also on Facebook as well, and it's called Effian Cards. Right, so what we'll do now, I'll give you all my spiel, test this should fit in there nicely. And it does. Perfect fit. So we'll pop our tape to one side and pop all of this away because we don't need that. To save time for purposes of the video, I went ahead and I've already made the other three drawers and I've stuck them all together. So now all that we need to do is to stick this one on the top like so. And I don't know about you, but I think the colours just pop. I think it looks absolutely beautiful. You know, I never used to be a pink type of girl, but I love pink, black and white. I think it's just so classy. So what we'll do is we'll take this double-sided tape off here, off the top. On all of these ones, I meant to say, just put some sticky tape on the top and then you just sit your box on top like that. So we'll take off this double-sided tape once I can get it off. Tell you what, might be better if I take that drawer out and flatten it. This is the way I construct them. I just flatten them a little bit and then it makes it easier to grab hold of the release paper and take it off. Take that drawer out of there while I put it on. Just to make sure. So then what you want to do is you can either hold it up like this and then put it straight on, or you could flatten it and put it on like that way. I'm just gonna do it this way. See if I can get it lined up as straight as possible. I'm happy with that. Yep, and then you just press it down like that. And then it's ready for your drawers to go back in. There's the third, that one back in. And the one we've just done, we'll just pop that inside like so. Right, what we'll do next is we'll put the base on. What I've done is, I meant to keep some out to do on camera, but I've just prepped them all and put them all together. And what I've done is, these panels are 3 1/8 by 2 3/4, and it's in Flirty Flamingo cardstock again. I've cut three of them and then I've just glued them with some Tombow one on top of the other, just nice rigid base, just for something to sit on. Excuse me. What I've also done though, I've cut another three, because my plan is, after I've got the sides and the back in, I'm going to have some on the top, and then I'm going to have a base on the bottom. I just think it really, really look pretty. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll put that on. Just, make sure you're in shot. And just plenty of Tombow on the bottom. I probably would advise Tombow. The tear and tape is fantastic, but with the Tombow, it allows for a little bit of wiggle room to make sure that you're getting it in the place where you want it. Once you're happy with where it's lined up, I think that looks good to me. I'm just going to turn it upside down like so, and I just like to get my bone folder just to make sure that that's stuck down. Tombow doesn't take long, it just needs a couple of seconds just to grip. Oh, my drawers are falling out. And there we go, there's our little base on, as you can see. Now what we'll do, it's time for it to do our back panel. And obviously I've got it all prepped here just to save time. This back panel measures 6 1/8 by 2 7/8. And then on the short side, the 2 7/8 side, if you score it at 1/4 inch and then rotate it and then do the same on the other side. This is just to, so it acts as a hinge to thing around the back. The panel, DSP panel for this is 5 7/8 by 2 1/8. And then like I said, I've just used my flirty flamingo marker just to pick out little bits on here. Don't need too much, but you know, you can colour in as much or as little as you like. I've already prepped this with some other double-sided tape because this my other one wasn't thin enough for it. This one needs to be quite a nice thin tape. So we'll just get rid of these. Like so. And what I should have done first is I should have folded and burnished them, but I didn't. Oops. Don't do my mistake. As you can tell, I still get a bit nervous when I'm doing videos. What I'll do is I'll bend them back that way, just to make sure that, see if I can do it that way. I always remember to fold and burnish. Oops, stuck to my grid paper. I do apologise for this. But I'm not going to edit it. You know, that's what bloopers are for, aren't they? Right, so yeah. Then what you do is decide which way you're having. What I do is I just line it up like that. And then just press that down on each side like so. And then once you've got one side on, it is easier to do the second side like so. Obviously this one's giving us a bit of trouble because I didn't, this is the side I didn't get burnished properly. Like I said, don't copy my mistakes, learn from them. But it'd be all good. So there it is, there's the back panel on, and I must admit that looks really, really nice. Then we've got some side panels as well, and again, I've already prepped these. These side panels measure 6 1/8 by 2 3/4, and obviously you need two of these. And then the DSP to go on, it measures 5 7/8 by 2 1/2. Again, I've used that marker to pick up some of the designs there. This is just going to sit on here like that. So I'm going to attach that with some of our liquid glue, just to allow for some wiggle room. Plenty of Tombow on there. It's more than I need, but you know, you can never be too careful. And then just line that up on here and give it as level as you can. Doesn't matter if some of your glue eases out, it dries clear. That's the beauty of the Tombow. Apart from the fact that it does give you a nice little bit of wiggle room. Again, using my bone folder just to make sure that that's all stuck down. And I know I'm a bit biased, but I think it's looking really, really nice. I love how it looks. Excuse me. We'll put the second panel on now. Oh, once my Tombow wants to work. And then again, just line that up at the bottom, like so. And yeah, make sure it's nice and flush as can be. Just turned on the side, it's easier to make sure that it's all caught nicely. So there we go. We're not far off finish now, so it's great that my video won't be as long as the last one. That one was a nightmare. But I did appreciate everybody who stayed till the very end. Right, as I was saying before about the top, this is the one I've made earlier, and this is just going to sit on there like so. So again, I'll put some glue on the top of the drawer like so. You could have used some of the tear and tape, but this was easy to hand. Again, just line it up, make sure you're happy with everything where it's positioned, and then just hold it for a second while it get there in there, and it might be easy if we put that in there like that. Sorry, turned upside down, take the drawer out, and then you can push that on there and make sure that it is fixed to that. There we go. And we just pop that drawer back in there like so. And then for the finishing touches, what I didn't do on the other one, what I've decided to do is I've cut a piece of basic black card, at 2.5 by 2 7/8. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pop it on the top for a little bit extra decoration. And then what I've also done, out of that DSP I've used, I had to cut into another sheet, unfortunately. But I cut out this flower that is in the middle, and I just think it is so pretty. I'm going to stick that onto here like so, and then pop that on the top. I just think it'll give it that nice little finished look. So I'll glue the flower onto our piece of basic black card. Just use Tombow again. I'm only going to keep it in the middle, just in case some of it actually does come over the sides. I haven't tried this. This was just an idea I wanted, and I thought, oh, I really like that. I'm going to stick it all over me. So it would look something like that. And then what I think might look nice, I'm going to pop some dimensionals on the underside of it. And I think that'll just be really nice, give it a bit of a lift. I'm going to use 5, one in each corner, and then one in the middle, just to make sure the middle doesn't sag. This is nothing worse. So just pop it on like that. Take off the backing. One more to go. And just bring your storage caddy over, and just center that on the panel like so. And I just think that looks really, really nice. I think it just finishes off really nicely. So here it is, from the side, the back, the other side, and then the front. And as you can see, I've got one of mine, got some more twines in here that we'll be able to pop in. So we've got 2 in that one. It will hold, 8 rolls of Stampin' Up twine, and I just think it's a really pretty way. Be nice to sit on your desk as storage. Obviously, I've only got 5 in here at the minute, but I just think it's beautiful. Thank you for watching today, and I really hope you like it. If you'd like to purchase any of the items that I've used today, then just remember to head on over to my blog or look on my Facebook page, and you'll be able to shop there. Don't forget to put in the hostess code, and this will entitle you to enter my rewards club. And then at the end of the month, when I close that reward, then you'll get some free Stampin' Up goodies. Thank you all for watching. Bye for now.